弟兄姊妹平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
我们一起来读神的话语。
Let's read the verses for today.
今天的经文还是在以弗所书四章一节到六节。
A scripture from today is still from Ephesians chapter 4.
我来念单数节，然后请弟兄姊妹们念双数节。
I'll read single verses and brothers and sisters, please read even verses.
第一节，我为主被囚的劝你们，既然蒙召，行事为人就当与蒙召的恩相称。
I therefore, prisoner for the Lord, urge you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling to which you have been called.
凡事谦虚温柔忍耐，用爱心互相宽容。
With all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing one another in love.
用和平彼此联络。竭力保守圣灵所赐合而为一的心。
Eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
真理只有一个，圣灵只有一个，正如你们蒙召同有一个指望。
Therefore, there is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the whole one hope that belongs to your call.
一主，一信一喜。
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
一神就是众人的父，超乎众人之上，冠乎众人之中，也住在众人之内。
One God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all.
感谢主，愿他祝福他自己的话语。
Praise to be Lord, please bless us.
我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray.
在天父主啊，我们感谢你，我们赞美你。
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you.
谢谢你。赐我们永生。
Thank you, give us the salvation.
谢谢你在主耶稣基督里面拯救了我们，让我们成为你的儿女。
Thank you for saving us in Christ, and we become your people.
谢谢你用圣灵重生了我们，让我们成为教会的一部分。
Thank you, the Holy Spirit gave us new life, and we be a part of the church.
谢谢你所赐下的宝贵的话语，让我们知道你怎么样在我们中间动工，让我们得以合一。
Thank you for your words that we know how the Holy Spirit is working among us and how we can unify in the church.
也求主继续的指教我们。
Pray that you continue to lead us.
让我们知道如何保守合一。
Let us know how to maintain unity.
靠着圣灵。
Rely on the Holy Spirit.
使我们的教会得以荣耀你。
So we can, as a church, praise you, glorify you.
与我们同在。
Please be with us.
祷告奉耶稣基督宝贵得胜的名。
In Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
今天是行在合一中的第五讲。
Today is the fifth sermon for maintaining walking unity.
感谢主，让我们在过去的四讲里面具体的讲到如何的保守合一。
Thanks to the Lord, in the past four sermons, we learn how to maintain unity.
我们过去四讲里面经文主要是集中在以弗所书第四章的第一节到第三节。
In the previous sermon, we mainly discussed about chapter 4, verse 1 to 3.
从今天开始呢，我们要把我们的注意力主要集中在第四节到第六节。
So starting from today, we'll focus on chapter 4, verse 4 to 6.
从第四节到第六节，保罗的重点有所转移。
Starting from chapter 4 to chapter 6, Paul switched his focus.
他主要放在合一的根据上面。
He starts focusing on the cause of the unity.
大家刚才所读的经文里面可以注意到，一共出现了七个一。
In the verses we read today, there were seven ones.
在第四节里面有一个身体，一个圣灵。一个指望。
In verse 4, there's one body, in verse 4, one body, one Holy Spirit, one hope.
第五节里面，一主，一信，一喜。
Verse 5, one Lord, one faith, one baptism.
第六节，一神。
Verse 6, one God.
所以呢，一共有七个一。
So we have seven ones.
我们再仔细看呢，发现这三节是按照圣灵、圣子、圣父的顺序是围绕着神的三个位格来展开的。
As we can see, these three verses have in the order of Holy Spirit, Holy Son, Holy Father, and it starts from these three identities.
第四节是围绕着圣灵合一的工作。
Verse 4 is around the topic of the work done by the Holy Spirit.
所以这里面其中中间这个一个圣灵就是这一节的中心。
So the central piece is the one Holy Spirit.
第五节呢，我们看到一主，指的是主耶稣基督。
Verse 5, we see that one Lord, which is Jesus Christ.
所以第五节的这个中心呢，是主耶稣基督的工作。
Central piece of verse 5 is the work done by Jesus Christ.
最后当然第六节是讲到父神。
The last verse, verse 6 is about one God, one Father.
那么对于这个经文初步的这个观察呢，我们可以学到几个功课。
We learn a couple lessons by looking at those three verses.
显然保罗在这三节经文里面对合一是非常非常的强调。
So Paul obviously emphasized on unity in these three verses.
用了七个一。
Used seven ones.
其实在第六节里面又用了四个众人。
In verse 6, it used for all, the word all.
其实也是为了强调合一。
But it's also in order to emphasize one.
就是强调这个合一的原则用在教会全体。
To emphasize the unity in the church.
所以出现了七个一，我们当然知道七是神完全的数字。
So as we can see, there are seven ones. Seven is the meaning of completion.
保罗有可能在这里是强调神的完全。
Probably Paul is emphasizing on the God's perfection and completion.
因为的确，合一的根据本来就是神自己的属性。
Because they are the cause of unity is part of God's character.
这是我们可以看到的第二点。
This is the second point that we can see.
也就是说，教会的合一是反映了三位一体的神三个位格之间的合一。
So the unity of church is reflecting the three in one.
属神的教会本来就是应该合一的。
A church which belongs to God is supposed to be unified.
第三点呢，我们也看到合一是神的工作。
The third point that we can see, unity is a work done by God.
是三位一体的神三个位格一同参与的工作。
The God is three in one.
这个合一不是人手所能造出来的。
This unity is not done by human.
我们的责任就像之前所说的，是要竭力保守神所赐的合一。
Our responsibility is to maintain. The unity of spirit given by God.
好，这个初步的观察之后，我们再来仔细的看，第四节啊。
Now we look in detail about verse 4.
我们今天讲到的时间，剩下来就会集中在第四节。
We'll focus on verse 4 today.
身体只有一个，圣灵只有一个，正如你们蒙召同有一个指望。
There is one body and one spirit.Just as you were called to the one hope that belongs to your call.
这一节讲到是以围绕圣灵为中心的，这个神的合一的工作。
The centerpiece of this verse is the one Holy Spirit.
那么，首先要解决个问题：为什么是圣灵、圣子、圣父的顺序，而不是平常我们所讲的？父子灵的顺序呢
？So there is a question. Why is this in the order of Holy Spirit, Holy Son, Holy Father, not in the order of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit?
为什么第四节是从圣灵的工作开始，而不是先从圣父的工作开始呢
？Why verse 4 start with the Holy Spirit, not the Holy Father?
答案有这几点哈。
A couple answers.
第一个，教会里经历到的首先是圣灵的工作。
Number one, church experience the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit first.
就是我们在教会里的弟兄姊妹，首先能够感受到、观察到的是圣灵的工作。
We brothers and sisters in church can first experience the work done by Holy Spirit in church.
我们知道五旬节的时候，圣灵降临，建立教会。
As we all know, in Pentecost, the Holy Spirit come down and build the church.
圣灵带领人认罪悔改，使人重生。
Holy Spirit lead us to repent and give us salvation.
接受耶稣基督为救主，成为神的儿女，归入教会。
So we can accept Christ as the Lord and become God's people and be included in the church.
所以这些都是我们在教会里面所经历的圣灵的工作。
So those are the works that's done by the Holy Spirit to the church.
圣灵也带领人成圣。
Spirit also gave us the holy life.
圣灵也赐下合一。
Holy Spirit gave us unity.
这第四章第三节啊，之前讲到竭力保守圣灵所赐的合而为一的心。
Verse 4 mentioned that eager to maintain the unity of Holy Spirit.
那么接下来第四节再讲圣灵的工作也是非常自然的。
So obviously it makes sense that verse 4 is talk about the work done by Holy Spirit.
那么接下来第五节讲到圣子，就是耶稣基督。
Then verse 5's focus is the Holy Son, Jesus Christ.
因为基督是教会的头。
Because Christ is the head of the church.
也是因为若不是圣父和圣子差下圣灵，也就不会有圣灵在教会里的工作。
So that if the Holy Spirit not given by Holy Father and Holy Son, then the work done in church is not by Holy Spirit.
然后呢，第六节讲到圣父。
Then verse 6 focus on Holy Father.
有这个顺序是因为圣子顺服圣父。
This order is because Holy Son obeys Holy Father.
若不是圣父赐下独生爱子，也就没有十架上的救赎。
Holy Father did not send his only beloved son, then there is no salvation by the cross.
所以最后要讲到圣父。
Then last, the focus is on Holy Father.
他就是众人的父。
It's the Father of all.
超乎众人之上。
Above all.
冠乎众人之中。
Through all.
也住在众人之内。
Father in all.
这里反复用了众字，就是包括了所有神的儿女。
Repeatedly use the word all, which means that includes everybody, which belongs to God.
这也是再次的来强调合一。
Again, it's emphasizing on the unity.
好，那我们进一步再来讲啊，第四节里面围绕着圣灵的工作赐下合一，具体是什么意思？
Let's see the let's say exactly what I mean, verse 4, about work done by Holy Spirit and unity given by the Holy Spirit.
我们知道关于圣灵的工作有许多许多的内容可以讲。
We know there are a lot of information about Holy Spirit we can discuss.
我们今天只能选其中一些相关的。
Today we can only pick a few of them to talk about.
首先我们看身体只有一个。
So one body.
这个原文里面只有两个词。就是一身体，一这个词，还有身体这个词。
In the original text, there are only two words. There's one and body. So one body.
就像第五节这个一主一信一喜同样的这个句式。
Just like verse 5, the pattern of one Lord, one faith, one baptism.
这个身体显然指的是耶稣基督在地上的身体。
This body obviously means that the human body Christ has in the earth.
也就是，之前我们几次讲到讲了神圣的大公教会。
Previously we discussed the Holy Catholic Church.
即历世历代古今中外过去现在将来所有真正得救的圣徒的全体。
This church of the saved saints throughout the history from different parts of the world previously, nowadays, and in the future.
我们也称之为普世教会或者宇宙性的教会。
We also call this the universal church,
或者无形的教会
or invincible church.
这样圣而公的教会只有一个。
This church of holiness and righteousness there is only one such church that's holiness and righteousness.
所以身体只有一个。
So there is only one body.
这区别于各个时期分散在各地的无数有形的地方教会。
It's differentiate from different local church throughout history from different parts of the world.
那么为什么保罗在这里强调主的身体的唯一呢？
Why is Paul emphasizing on the unity of the body?
这里啊，我们可以看几个有限的有限的一方面。
There is a limited point for this.
因为我们到了下面七到十六节还有更详细的解释。
We'll discuss in detail when we get to verse 7 to verse 16.
这里保罗要强调耶稣基督身体的唯一性。他是为了提醒我们， 必须时时以自己为基督身体的一部分为来行事为人。
So here Paul emphasized on the unity of Christ, which is telling us to be part of the body of Christ.
我们人呢，天然是以个人为中心的。
Us as human, we always self-centered by nature.
很自然，首先都是从自己的出发来考虑事情。
Obviously, everything we think about is from our own thinking.
比如说，爱自己是不需要教的。
For example, self-love is does not to be taught.
世界上和教会里的问题那么多，不是因为人不知道怎么爱自己。
There are too many problem issues in church and in this society. It's not because people do not know how to love themselves.
而是太爱自己了。
But it's because they love themselves too much.
所以世界上有很多的鸡汤啊，要教我们怎么样来爱自己，甚至在教会里面也教这些东西。实际上不仅不能帮助个人和教会，反而是会害了。
So there are a lot of chicken soup around in the society that teach like how to be better, but it's not going to teach us the real, the truth.
所以在这里呢，是要提醒我们，成为主的肢体，就意味着要从这一个全新的身份来考虑各样的事情。
So here, in order to be part of Christ,we need to have this new identity and think everything through this new identity, from this new identity.
包括我们之前所学的，为保守合一所要做的四件事情。
Including what we learned first, in order to maintain unity, there are four things we need to do.
谦虚、温柔、忍耐、宽容。
Humility, gentleness, patience, and bearing one another.
也是要从这个我们作为一个身体里面的一部分，这个角度来考虑。
Also from the point, from the perspective of us being part of the body.
那，我们要常常问自己的一个问题，就是说，我们到底是为了什么要做这四件事情
？A question we should always ask us: Why are we doing things? Why are we doing those four things?
是为了显得自己有礼貌、有教养吗
？Is it because we want to show off that we are?We have gentleness and well taught.
是为了自保，不得罪人，不惹麻烦吗
？Is that because we want to protect ourselves, not offend everyone, not cause any trouble?
还是为了基督身体的缘故，宁可自己吃亏，保守圣灵所赐的合一呢
？Or because of we are part of Christ's body, rather we take some loss, still want to maintain the unity of the Holy Spirit.
所以保罗在这里强调，基督身体的。这个唯一性啊，是要我们来思想这些问题。
So Paul here want us to think about why they are the only body, only Christ's body that we are part of.
那么这样四件事能够行出来，必要靠着圣灵。
Doing those four things have to be rely on the Holy Spirit.
而这个基督的身体，圣而工的教会，本身就是圣灵工作的结果。那我们下面就来看这个一灵啊，一个灵。
Here the Christ's body and the universal church are part of the results of the work done by the Holy Spirit. Now we look at a couple points.
就是这第四节当中的圣灵只有一个。
So it's same as verse 4, there's one Holy Spirit.
原文里面也只有两个词，就是一灵。
In the original text, there are two words, one Spirit.
这个里面告诉我们，首先呢。圣灵只有一位。
Here, so it means that there is only one Spirit.
无论圣灵在多少不同的时代，在不同的地方教会，住在多少圣徒当中，都单单只有一位圣灵。
Doesn't matter if throughout history, different parts of the world, different local churches, among different saints, there is only one Holy Spirit.
也就是说，如果我们得着了圣灵，就是百分之百。
Which means if we receive the Holy Spirit, it means we receive it 100%.
不能说我刚信主的时候，因为道行比较浅啊。
It's not like that when we first accept Christ, our theology is still shallow.
所以只得到了一部分圣灵。
We just got part of the Holy Spirit.
然后呢，以后进步了，得到第二次或更多次的祝福之后， 才能得到全部圣灵。
And then, as we improve, we got more blessed, and then we got more Holy Spirit.
不是那样的哈。
It's not like that.
那么这里就要提醒大家，这个关于圣灵论里面最基本的一点啊。
So here we have to remind people that the fundamental point of the Holy Spirit.
就是圣灵是有位格的。
So Holy Spirit has its own identity.
它是永活的真神。
It's a long-lived God.
它是有自己思想、意志、情感的主体。
It has its own thinking, will, emotion as an entity.
所以不能把圣灵理解成一种无人格的力量。
So it cannot be understood as a power with no characters.
就好像某种能量或者气啊。
Just like some power,
Or energy.
Energy.
我今天灌一点。
Today I got some.
明天少了再灌一点。
Tomorrow I got less, so I need more.
这个是对圣灵的本质的误解。
It's a misunderstanding of the Holy Spirit.
讲到圣灵只有一个，这也和邪灵形成鲜明的对比。
When we say that there is only one Holy Spirit, it's in a very large, it's obvious contrast, or with the evil spirit.
邪灵有很多的。
There are too many impure and evil spirits.
就在以弗所书六章十二。节里面这样讲，告诉我们。
In Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12,
因我们并不是与属血气的征战，乃是与那些执政的、掌权的、管辖这幽暗世界的，以及天空属灵气的恶魔征战。
For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers, over the present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places.
这里执政的、掌权的、管辖这幽暗世界的，以及天空属灵气的恶魔，都是复数。
So here they are the rulers, authorities, cosmic powers, and spiritual forces of evil are all the even verse.
所以邪灵是复数。
They are so evil spirits is plural.
福音书里面也记着主耶稣在格拉森一带，从一个人身上赶出许多的鬼。
In the New Testament, in the Gospels, that also recorded that Christ was taken out of the impure spirits in the region of Gerasene.
最后导致2000头猪投水自杀。
Which resulted in 2,000 pigs jumping off the lake and drowned.
旧约也告诉我们，真神只有一位，而以色列人却常效法外邦人敬拜众多偶像。
In the Old Testament, we know that there is only one true God. However, the Jewish worship a lot of idols, just like the Gentiles.
那背后都是各种的鬼魔。
And those idols are backed by evil spirits.
世界各国也各自有魔君掌管他们。
And different countries are controlled by different evil spirits.
所以呢？众多的邪灵实在也是混乱与不和的源头。
So, the root of the evil spirit, the root of the chaotic is backed by evil spirits.
是世界上的人彼此不能合一，常常征战的原因。
Which cause people cannot unify in the world, and their wars always happen.
当然，人因为犯罪背逆神，甘心投靠魔鬼，必然有此结果。
But obviously.You know, people disobey the Lord and willing to accept evil spirits, then the result is obviously like those bad things.
人不能把责任都推到鬼魔头上。
Human cannot blame everything on evil spirits.
而真神只有一位。
But there is only one true God.
圣灵只有一位。
Only one true Holy Spirit.
这实在是圣而公的普世教会能够合一的根据。
Those are the reasons that the universal church can unify.
而真正由这一位圣灵所建造的普世大公教会也必然是合一的。
So the universal church, built by this Holy Spirit, can obviously be unified.
不能分裂的。
Will not be divided.
因为神不是使人混乱的神。
Because God does not want us to be chaotic.
神是有规律的神。
God has orders.
我们从这个世界上有统一的科学规律就可以知道这一点。
So we can see the orders of the scientific orders in the earth, on this in the society. We know this order by God.
所以这是从圣灵只有一位，我们可以学到第一点。
This is what we learn from there is only one Holy Spirit.
第二点就是，既然圣灵是一位，他在各圣徒生命所当中所做的工是一样的。
Secondly, since there is only one Holy Spirit, and the work done by the Holy Spirit are the same.
我们在加拉太书五章二十二节看到圣灵所结的果子，有这九样。
From Galatians chapter 5, verse 22, we see there are nine things that are the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
就是仁爱、喜乐、和平、忍耐、恩慈、良善、信实、温柔、节制。
Which are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.
凡顺从圣灵的都会结出这样的果子。
If we were to obey the Holy Spirit, we'll have the fruit of the Spirit.
这不是说所有基督徒都应该从一个模子里刻出来那样，整齐划一，没有个性。
It doesn't mean that every Christian is from the same mold, in the same order, in the same uniform.
圣灵不仅仍然让我们保持个性，而且他在教会里赐下的恩赐也是各不相同。
The Holy Spirit will give us different gifts and we have different roles in the church.
使我们在基督有机的身体里面各司其职，互相配搭。
So we have different roles in the body of Christ and then work together in Christ.
这个到了七到十六节呢，我们会有更多的解释。
When we get to verse 7 to 16, we'll have more details.
这点也是就是说，同一位圣灵会在各个圣徒生命当中结出这九样的果子，一样的果子。
Which means that the Holy Spirit will have the fruits of this nine type of fruits in Christians.
这也是圣徒相通的一个基础。
It's alright. Also, is the foundation of the saints' connections.
所以我们弟兄姊妹之间呢，有这样的真实的体验，就是真基督徒之间虽然初见面，却常有心有灵犀一点通的感觉。
So that you know we as true Christians that when we see other Christians the first time, there are some inner connections.
那么与此相对比呢，凡顺从肉体的就生出各样的罪来。
In contrast, if we belong to flesh, then there are too many sins from the flesh.
就在这个加拉太书五章的前几节，十九节到二十一节。
Just like in the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 19 to 21.
保罗列举了很多罪的这个具体的表现。
Paul specified many samples of sins.
情欲的事都是显而易见的，就如奸淫、污秽、邪荡、拜偶像、邪术、仇恨、争竞、记恨、恼怒、结党。纷争、异端、嫉妒、醉酒、荒宴等类，我从前告诉你们，现在又告诉你们，行这样事的人，必不能承受神的果。
Now the works of the flesh are evident: sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, rivalries, dissensions, divisions, envy, drunkenness, orgies, and things like this.I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God.
所以正是这些罪导致教会不能合一。
Because of these sins, church cannot be unified.
具体历史环境中的地方教会啊，因为不能完全避免这些罪，所以会有纷争和分裂。
Throughout the history, the local church cannot avoid those things completely, so there are divisions, decisions, rivalries.
那么我们竭力保守圣灵所赐的合一，尽量避免纷争分裂的事情，我们怎么来做呢？
So how do we how do we be eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit? What should we do?
那么我们就要来看圣灵工作的下一个特点。
Let's see the next characters of the Holy Spirit.
第三点就是圣灵使人重生，并将重生的基督徒纳入这个圣而工的教会里面。
The third point is Holy Spirit will give people salvation, and those who saved, those Christians who saved will be included in the universal church.
中马田牧师对这一点的阐释，令人非常有启发。
Pastor Martin Floyd Jones have a very inspirational understanding of this.
当然，大家也知道我的讲到内容有很多其实是抄他的。
Obviously, people know that there are a lot of information I copied from Pastor Martin Floyd Jones.
我们看到以弗所书二章里面，保罗用房屋来比喻教会。
In Ephesians chapter 2, Paul uses houses as a parable to church.
第二章二十一节。各房靠他联络得合适，渐渐成为主的圣殿，你们也靠他同被建造，成为神借着圣灵居住的所在。
Ephesians chapter 2 verse 12, 21 to 22, in whom the whole structure being joined together grows into a holy temple in the Lord. In him you also are being built together into a dwelling place for God by the Spirit.
保罗可能是想到了旧约建圣殿的那个情景。
Probably Paul was thinking about the in the Old Testament, people were building the temple.
中马天牧师提醒说，建圣殿的石头是在采石场就凿好的。
Martin Lloyd Jones, remind us that they are the rock that's fundamental for the temple were well made in the quarry.
在建圣殿的那个地方是听不到凿石头的声音的。
In the place that's building the temple, you cannot hear the sound of making the rock.
那里的工作就是让各块石头各就其位，联络得合适。
The work there was to piece together different rocks and being joined together.
这可以让我们明白圣灵建造教会的方法。
This help us to understand how.The Holy Spirit is building the church.
圣灵先让人重生，再纳入教会。
The Holy Spirit will give salvation to people, and then those people be included in the church.
在时间上，这两样可以是同时发生的。
These two things can happen at the same time in the time frame.
但逻辑上，必须是重生的人才是圣而公教会的成员。
But logically, only if the person is have a reborn life.They can be part of this universal church.
就像石头在采石场被拣选和预备了，才会成为圣殿的一部分。
Just like the rock is well made and prepared in the quarry, then the rock can be part of the temple.
这样圣殿各部分才是合一的，或者是和谐的。
So that different parts of the temple can be unified.
整个建筑才可以伫立起来，长久不倒。
And the whole structure can stand in for a long time without collapse.
可惜地方教会在实践中常常违背这一原则。
However, in practice, local churches always don't follow this principle.
教会用世俗的方法吸引人进来，以增加教友数量。
Some local churches try to use earthly strategy to increase the members of the church.
却不重视他们是否明白真理，是否真正重生得救。
And not really caring about whether they understand the truth and whether they are really being saved.
就像把没有挑选、没有加工过的石头乱堆起来，却期望能建起一座整齐坚固的房子。
Just like when you build the house, you pick any rock you find. Doesn't matter if it's good or not.
这当然是不可能的。
Of course, it's not possible.
这些没有重生的人必然成为教会合一的障碍，就像定时炸弹一样，迟早会成为教会纷争分裂的因素。
Those who do not have the real salvation.Will be the barriers of the church being unified, just like the bomb can explode anytime.
神重生是圣灵的工作。
Our salvation is part of the work done by the Holy Spirit.
我们的主在于尼哥底母的谈话中讲了重生的道理。
When Lord Christ was talking with Nicodemus,
就是圣灵凭己意。当然也是和圣父圣子的意思是一致的。
The conversation is, the Holy Spirit by itself, of course, same with you know, Holy Father, Holy Son, is given to us from the heaven, the new life given to us from heaven.
对，从天上赐下新生命给我们，就是耶稣基督的生命在我们里面。
Just like the new life given to us from the heaven, and that is just like the Christ living inside ourselves.
使我们有了全新的身份。
So we have the new identity.
这是神在我们的生命里造成的真正的革命。
So this is the Lord's revolution inside of us.
而不是靠我们自己改良。
It's not by our own manner.
只有这样的生命才能合进神的圣日宫的教会。
We can only be included in the universal church if we have this type of life.
那我们能够做什么呢？
So what can we do?
好好的传全备的福音。
Preach the whole, spreading the whole gospel.
带领人做基督的真门徒。
Lead people to be the true Christians.
尽量减少人混进教会假装做基督徒的机会。
Try to avoid people who come to church and to be a fake Christians.
那么圣灵会做他分别的工作，将神的拣选显明出来。
Then, the Holy Spirit will do its own work and select the real people.
好，这是讲到圣灵做合一工作的第三个方面。
This was the third point of the unity done by Holy Spirit.
第四个方面是圣灵使教会充满活力。
The fourth point is that the Holy Spirit gave church full of energy.
圣灵不仅建立教会，而且使教会充满活力。
Holy Spirit not only built the church, but also gave church the whole energy.
教会合一和侍奉的动力来自圣灵。
So they are the motivation for to serve in church and unify in church is from the Holy Spirit.
在五旬节的时候，门徒们经历圣灵的洗，也使他们大有能力为主做见证。
In Pentecost, the apostles were baptized by the Holy Spirit and also can give great testimony for the Lord.
做工大有果效。
They have big results.
神也借着保罗吩咐我们要常常被圣灵充满。
Also, by God, Paul commands us to always be full of Holy Spirit.
就是我们的生命要常被圣灵掌管。
Which means our life need to be controlled by the Holy Spirit.
当教会陷入低沉冷淡的时候，我们需要到主面前认罪悔改。
When the church has some downtime and quiet times, we need to come back to the Lord and repent.
求圣灵光照，看我们生命里面有什么需要被对付，有什么阻碍圣灵动工的。
Pray for the light and see what we need to improve, what we need to correct in our lives in order to remove those barriers by the Holy Spirit.
圣灵工作的这个第五点，我简单讲一下。
Now remember, the fifth point is for the Holy Spirit.
就是圣灵在教会当中会做更新和复兴的工作。
Is that there will be renewal and revival work done by the Holy Spirit?
我们看到教会的历史上有一些循环。
We see there are cycles throughout the church history.
就是教会在一段时间兴盛被主大大使用之后，会陷入低沉冷淡，甚至堕落腐败。
And that there will always be some quiet time after the prosperous time in the church.
但之后圣灵会复兴教会。
And then the Holy Spirit will revive the church.
使徒行传记载了初代教会美好的见证。
In Acts recorded the great testimonies by the early churches.
但基督教成为罗马国教之后，有许多的腐败堕落。
But when Christianity become Catholic, there are a lot of corruptions.
一直到宗教改革来复兴教会。
Not until Reformation that there are revival of church.
但新教教会后来有许多的冷淡、堕落、腐败。
Then they are the newly built the new church that has some downtime of falling corruptions.
而圣灵又曾在欧洲、苏格兰、北美等地兴起复兴。
And then Holy Spirit revived the church in Europe, part of Europe, Scotland, and North America.
其果实一直影响至今。
And we can even see the result today.
但今天我们看各个教会的情景，知道我们又需要复兴。
Now we see the different situation in the church. We know that we need another revival.
而我们知道我们需要的并不是外在的数量和组织上的复兴。
We know that we don't need the external and the quantity of church members revival for that.
而实在是需要这同一位圣灵， 也就曾经在历史上多次更新和复兴教会的同一位圣灵。
But we need this one Holy Spirit, which is, has been giving, has been revived churches through the history.
再次的使人能够认罪悔改。
And again, make us repent.
由里到外的改变我们生命的状况。
From inside to outside, to change, make us repent.
我们能做的是祷告，预备自己，愿意付代价。
What we can do is to pray, prepare ourselves, and willing to take risk.
来承受复兴。
So we can get this revival.
因为真正的复兴一定会让我们更多的放弃自己，放弃自己的好处，放弃世上的好处。
So in order to get this revival, we need to give up our own selfishness and our own things.
最后我们看到以弗所书第四章第四节最后那一段。
And lastly, we see that in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 4,
因为这里讲到一个指望。
Here there is talk about one hope.
正如你们蒙召同有一个指望。
Just as you were called to the one hope that belongs to your call.
这也是圣灵的工作。
This also work done by the Holy Spirit.
那么为什么在这里讲到这个同一个指望呢？
Why here to talk about this one hope?
这个跟合一有什么关系呢？
What does this have to do with unity?
我们先来看这个指望到底是什么指望。
Let's see what is this hope first.
那么以弗所书第一章已经告诉我们。
Ephesians chapter 1 already told us.
第十节到第十一节。
Verse 10 to 11.
要照所安排的，在日期满足的时候，使天上地上一切所有的都在基督里面同归于一。我们也在他里面得了基业。
As a plan for the fullness of time to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In him we have obtained an inheritance.
所以我们盼望耶稣基督作王，我们也与他一同作王掌权。
So we look for that Christ to be the king, and we also can be on the same position and be in charge of the entire everything.
我们也指望将得到基督里所有的一切。
So we also want, look forward to inherit everything, from in Christ.
也就是永恒美好天地里的一切，我们都能够得到。
So everything, you know, from the earth, in earth, in heaven, on earth, we can inherit all of them.
这是何等大的应许
！What a great promise!
而且圣灵是亲自住在我们里面，作为我们得赎的印记和得基业的凭据，让我们确信这应许是有绝对保证的。
And because the Holy Spirit lives inside us, we have signs of salvation, and it made us to believe that this inheritance is guaranteed.
除非圣灵光照，我们没有办法想象，也没有办法接受这样的应许。
If not by the Holy Spirit, we cannot imagine, we cannot accept this promise.
所以保罗一定要在第一章里面祷告，求圣灵光照我们，让我们可以看见。
So Paul in the first chapter has been praying that pray for light so that we can see.
那么这个圣灵的工作是面向将来的。
So this work done by the Holy Spirit is for the future.
让我们对主所应许的将来有坚实的盼望。
So that we have hope.In the future that promised by God.
那么和教会的合一有什么关系呢？
What does this have to do with the unity of the church?
是大有关系。
There is tight relationship.
因为教会里面的许多不合一，肢体之间的纷争分裂，是因为人生活在过去和现在。
Because there are too many dissensions, rivalries, quarrels, in the church, which cause church not to be unified is part of the human past and human present.
有人常忘了主已经赐给我们的新生命、新身份和新盼望，全新的未来和前途。
People often forget the new life given by God, new identity given by God, new hope and future given by God.
而缠累于过去世界上的旧身份、旧习惯、旧眼光。
Always stay in the same old identity, same old manner and vision.
当年以弗所教会里面，恐怕要解决的是犹太人和外邦人之间，因为过去的身份习惯， 有过去历史上彼此的敌对而带来的纷争的可能。
In the church officials, they need to solve the issue of Jewish and Gentile. They have different status, different identity, different manners.
尽管以弗所书前几章已经讲得很清楚。
Although the Ephesians, in the first couple of chapters, Ephesians already very clear that.
在基督耶稣里重生的弟兄姊妹。
People reborn, truly reborn in Christ,
不再有犹太人或外邦人之分。
There are no identity as such as Jewish and Gentile.
也就是说，曾经是犹太人的，在教会里不再是犹太人。
Which means if you were Jewish, but in church you are no longer Jewish.
曾经是外邦人的，在教会里不再是外邦人。
If you were Gentile, then in church you are no longer Gentile.
在基督里，大家都是新人，有了新的身份。
In Christ, everybody is a new person, have a reborn life, and have a new identity.
就是圣徒，都是神家里的弟兄姊妹。
Which is saints, God's people.
要一同承受神的产业。
Well, together and get inheritance of the Lord.
如果以弗所教会的弟兄姊妹都用这样新的、像未来的眼光彼此相看相待、合一，就可以保守。
If brothers and sisters in Church of Ephesians can use this new vision to see the future, then the unity can be maintained.
不仅仅是因为活在过去，如果人只是活在现在，教会里也不容易保守合一。
Not just for those who live in the past, but for people who live in the present, it's hard to maintain unity in church.
很多时候这关系到圣灵给教会赐下的恩赐。
Many times this has something to do with the gift given by Holy Spirit to the church.
正如保罗针对哥林多教会要处理的问题。
Just like Paul has to solve the issues in the church of Corinth.
教会各肢体所得的恩赐不同。
People in the church have different gifts from God.
如果大家只看重现在个人得到的恩赐，
because people only see that the gifts given by the Holy Spirit on each other in the present time,
也会造成纷争和分裂。
This will also cause the dissensions and divisions.
有的人得到恩赐大，
some people have a greater gift,
而且又是那些比较炫的，
and also something easy to show off.
Flashy, 容易显在人前。
It's easier to show off in front of people.
比如讲道、方言、医病赶鬼的。
Just like preaching, speaking dialogue, healing and removing the impure spirits.
得到这样恩赐的人呢，他就容易骄傲。
People with those gifts are easier to be arrogant.
而没有这样恩赐的人呢，容易去嫉妒这样的人。
Which cause people don't have those gifts to be envy and jealous.
哥林多教会就出现了这样的情况。
This is exactly what happened in the Church of Corinthians.
那我们现在的教会也可以学习这些功课。
So church nowadays can also learn from the same lesson.
一方面，我们不要活在过去。
One point that we don't live in the past.
不要还是用过去世界上的眼光和办法来处理事情。
Don't do things out of the earthly visions.
来看弟兄姊妹和自己。
Treating people around us.
不要用世界上的地位、财富、学问、种族，等等这些来对人分门别类。
Don't judge people by their status, wealth, degrees, race.
另一方面，也不要只活在现在。
A different perspective. Don't just live in the present.
不要用现在自己属灵的能力、资格、经历、经验等分门别类，彼此轻看。
Don't do things just by, don't look at other people just by their ability, experience, and status.
所以保罗说，我们有同一个盼望，就是说我们要存着同一的盼望，一同的成长。
As Paul mentions, we have one hope, which means we grow together by this one hope.
所以我们要来思想。
So we need to think about.
一方面比起将来要得到的，我们过去和今天所有的根本都不算什么。
Compared to what we will inherit in the future, what we have today and tomorrow is nothing.
保罗把过去世上的好处看作粪土。
Paul regards everything he has on earth as nothing.
他也提醒我们，今天我们所得的属灵恩赐与将来见主面所得的也相差甚远。
He also mentioned us what we get today is far less than what we'll get tomorrow.
他说我们现在通过这个属灵的恩赐啊，能够明白的。
Paul said that what we can understand by the Holy Spirit today.
就像通过模糊的铜镜来看。
Just like looking through a blurry glass.
而将来见主面的时候，是看得清清楚楚。
In the future, when we see Christ, we can see it clearly.
而另一方面呢，我们得着这么大的应许和盼望，都是不配得的。
Similarly, we are not worthy to have this great inheritance and hope.
所以啊，求主帮助我们有这样未来的眼光。
So that we pray God, so that we can have the vision of the future.
让我们看见自己的卑微。
See us ourselves to be very small and minimal.
看别人比自己强。
See others are better than us.
能存着同一的盼望。
So we can have the same hope.
凡事谦虚忍耐，温柔忍耐，用爱心互相宽容，用和平彼此联络，竭力保守圣灵所赐合而为一的心。
With all humility and gentleness, with patience bearing one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
在天父，我们感谢你，我们赞美你。
Dear Heavenly Father, we praise you with thank you.
啊，谢谢主你啊赐下的那丰富的恩典。
Thank you for the blessing you gave us.
谢谢你赐下宝贵的话语。
Thank you for your word.
来提醒我们。
And remind us.
来责备我们。
And make us repent.
来警告我们。
And warn us.
让我们的教会能够更健康的成长。
Let us let our church to continue grow in a healthy way.
让求主让圣灵的工作在我们中间更加的彰显。
We pray that the Holy Spirit can continue to do His work in us.
让我们弟兄姊妹的生命能够由里到外有更新。
And improve and change our lives from inside out.
更深的更新。
Deeply from inside out.
让我们这个教会能在这里为你更好的做金灯台。
So we can be a better testimony for you.
因为这个世界实在是需要主，你的教会来发光。
Because we need your church to shine the light.
因为你来的日子近了。
Because your time, your second coming is close.
我们求主使用我们，让世上更多的人。能够来认识。
We pray that God please use us so that more people can know you.
让我们见你面的时候，能够交账。
When we see you, we can give you the report.
让我们每个人都能得你的奖赏。
So that we can all inherit this great kingdom.
祷告奉耶稣基督宝贵得胜。
Praise in Christ's name.
Amen.
Amen.